I just want a guy who's gonna treat me nice, you know? So am I right or what? You know? You really are a gentleman. If you want to ask me out sometime, I just might say yes. I mean, that is, if Barry doesn't clean up his act, I mean. Anyway, I gotta get going. See you around, Mr. Mountie.
Come on, dear.
Here they come. Hold your positions.
You had any luck finding out who owns this place?
Yeah, it's a dummy corporation, which usually means mob money. I got a lien working on it right now. These things are pretty tough to crack.
They've got enough gas to burn down the whole block.
Let's get them.
Let's go.
You okay?
Yeah, just winged my guess.
Sorry, Jack. Maybe you were right. We should have let them take each other out.
Don't you think you're anything?
Maybe not.
Unbelievable.
What?
The police were at the warehouse, waiting for my guys.
Again? That's two times in a row.
Well, somebody must be talking.
Oh, no. No, not me.
If I find the leak, it is not going to be pretty.
Mr. Ordova.
If there's anything I could do, anything.
There might be.
So what do you feel like, Benny? Chinese, Italian, barbecue? It's your call.
Barbecue?
All right, I know a great place for ribs.
No, Ray. The rat I examined, her breath? It had the scent of barbecue sauce and barbecue ribs on it. It was partially digested, of course, which is why it took me so long to place it.
So what does that mean?
Well, Mount Olympus doesn't offer ribs on his menu, so that's probably not where the rat got the food.
So the rats were imported?
Well, possibly. So if we can locate the source of the sauce, then we may be able to find the saboteur who released the rats into Mount Olympus.
All right, so let's recap. I got a guy who talks in his sleep and a stripper who's ripping your clothes off.
No, I didn't say she was trying to rip my clothes off. I said she merely slipped her hand. It's not important.
Vecchio.
Detective, it's me, Ida.
Barry talked in his sleep again. It's bad this time. He's gonna kill someone. You dance because you love it, and then you dance to make money, and I don't mind the taking my clothes off part so much. I really don't. I mean, Isidore Duncan did say that clothes were dishonest anyway, and then you meet a guy, you think that he's the sweetest person in the whole world, and he ends up being a killer. Excuse me.
Ida, can we focus here?
Yeah, okay, I'm focused. I'm really focused. Can you get that teddy, please?
Ida, who did Barry say that he was going to kill?
Like, he's gonna tell me. Okay, I'm gonna be better off without him.
No, you can't leave him.
Well, Ray, she has to do what she thinks is right.
Benny, you wanna work with me here?
Look, Ida. You said that you loved him, right?
Yeah, I did.
All right, now, Barry, he's been under a lot of pressure lately, and he's not at his best.
You're just saying that because you want me to keep telling you what he says in his sleep.
If that's what it's going to take to prevent a murder, yes.
Ida, can you think of anyone who would want to hurt Barry?
Someone wants to hurt Barry?
Ida, he's into some pretty serious stuff here.
Yeah, well, you talk to him because he won't listen to me anymore anyway.
Ma'am, you're Teddy.
You know, I'm still available. That is, if you still want to go out with me sometime.
Ida, I hope I didn't mislead you in any way.
No. See, the invitation, it's still good. That is, if you're a decent guy and not a crumb like Barry.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Well, Bunny and I have to go.
Well, good night.
Good night.
Get the hell! Get on!
Tickle Tony's Rib Pit, the Rib Shack, Ribs O'Ronda, and Tickle My Ribs. I think you have all the ribs on the south side. Do you mind if I ask what's going on?
They're tasting them.
I can see that. I meant why.
You don't want to know.
Try me.
All right. Rat breath. Ah. I told you you don't want to know.
Don't wolf it down. You're supposed to taste it. Now remember, we're looking for a combination of jalapeno peppers and rockam honey in a 1-to-4 ratio.
You know, Fraser, we've been at this all morning. Do you mind if we move on?
Well, you could help me.
I don't think so. All right, I'm gonna go shake Barry's peaches.
Well, he hasn't done anything right. And if we can find the right sauce, we'll have found a piece of the larger picture.
You wanna know what the larger picture is? Me without a source. Now I gotta catch something for my troubles, even if it is a minnow like Barry.
Wait a minute.
Oh, that's disgusting.
This is it.
The Kit Kat Corral? This ain't no minnow.
Well, howdy, partners.
Howdy.
Yeah, howdy to you too, partner. We're looking for Litvak.
Well, you moseyed in the right saloon, buckaroos. I'm Litvak. What's on your mind?
Tomatoes, vinegar, sugar, both brown and white, mustard, Worcestershire sauce, and jalapeno peppers with rockam honey in a 1-to-4 combination.
Are you gonna bust me for my mother's rib recipe? Is that what you're gonna do?
No, how about 50 rats chasing the way to customers at Mount Olympus?
Hey, pal, don't blame me. Maybe those rats were just looking for one of their own kind.
Yeah, and maybe you're not up to the competition.
Mark Bordova, competition, hell. You must be kidding.
Howdy, Shelly.
Hello, girl. See that? That's the real reason I love this business.
Mr. Litvak, I'd like to take a look in your kitchen, if you don't mind.
What for?
Evidence linking you to the rats?
Hey, kid. You don't seriously think that I could go down for rat food, do you?
No, but he does, and that's all that counts.
Come on with me. The kitchen's back here.
That's all that counts. What the hell do you mean by that?
We want you to call a truce with Ordova.
Truce? Must be kidding. He'd only break it. That punk got the ethics of a rattlesnake.
Yeah, well, when he breaks it, you give me a call. Because if you get me something I can use on Ordova, maybe nobody has to know about the rats.
Fair enough, partner. Now, why don't you get along, little doggy? I have 75 candles to blow out tonight. Gotta conserve my breath.
Yeah, happy trails to you, partner.
Nelson.
Yes, Mr. Litvak.
I like that Mounty look. But I could do without those two guys frickin' frack. Make sure that I don't see them anymore. Do you understand me?
Okay, buddy.
This is the sauce. Ida? Is that you?
Oh, hi.
What are you doing here?
Making a living. They gave me a job. But I miss Barry.
Great. Well, not that you miss Barry, that maybe it's time for reconciliation.
I'm not going to get back together with Barry just so I can rat on him.
Well, not just so you can rat on him.
Don't you get it? I just want the old Barry back.
Well, if we don't find out who Barry's going to kill...
Ray, can I have a word with you?
Excuse me. We better talk to Welsh, put a 24-hour tail on this guy.
I think I'd like to try something else.
Excuse me.
It's private club, pal.
Well, actually, I came to see you.
Me? I know you?
No. But I know you.
That's a good one. I ain't heard that one in a long time. That's what guys used to say when they wanted me to throw a fight.
But you never did you?
No. No. But I might as well have. Hey, listen, Red, if you're gonna stand there and talk, why don't you come over here and hold the bag so I don't cool down?
All right. You know, I stopped at the library on the way over. Looked up some old articles on your career. It was very promising for a while.
Yeah, you win some, you lose some, right?
In the end, it seems you lost rather more than you won.
Listen, I fought my heart out every time.
You know, my friend Ray describes one of your fights. He bet a substantial amount of money on you.
If he wants his money back, tell him to forget it.
No, it's not about the money. What he describes is the third round. You'd hit your opponent with three solid hooks. His legs were rubbery, he was about to go down. All you needed was one more punch, yet you didn't have the heart to throw that punch. Your opponent recovered, they knocked you out in the fourth.
Hey, well, if I had to do it all over again, I'd throw the stupid punch.
But according to your record, you never did. And that's why people started calling you a loser.
Listen, I'm not a loser.
No, I know you're not. I know that. Particularly not to people who matter.
What's your point? Get to your point.
I'm a friend of Ida's. And we'll be at the 12th Street Grill at 7 o'clock. If you'd care to join us.
Hey, Barry, you wanted to see me?
Yeah, Mr. Dover, I had to tell you, I'm gonna have second thoughts.
Really?
Yeah, it's just that, well, I got some stuff to straighten out with Ida.
Wait a second, I thought that was over. I thought your mind was on the business at hand.
Well, it is, but believe me.
What's important to you? I mean, do you want to move up in the world? Or do you like the view from the bottom?
Well, I'm gonna be someone.
Then think about what's best for Barry right now.
Yeah, but Ida, she...
No, Barry, you're not listening. Think about it. I got a job for you, Leo.
Yeah, thanks, Elaine. Great work. Hey, Benny. Well, you were right about Litvak. He's the money behind the warehouse and that liquor dump.
Well, that's good. I thought you'd be here with Ida.
She'll be here. She just stopped home to change. How about Barry? Is he gonna come?
Well, I guess we'll know when he gets here.
You think he'd be a little more non-committal?
Well, I didn't put a gun to his head.
You know, Benny, you need a good luck charm. Something that'll give you a little more optimism.
I happen to think I'm very optimistic, right?
All right, then tell me that Barry's gonna show. Did you feel it in your gut?
Well, I can't. Empirically, I don't know whether he's gonna show.
See? No optimism.
All right. Excuse me. Yeah. We'll have four menus, please. Is that as normal?
Yeah, it's a start.
Thank you kindly.
Back to her apartment, goes to the John, that's 2 minutes.
She applies her makeup, that's an additional 10 minutes.
Changes her clothes, 5 or 6 more.
Something's wrong.
Let's go.
Pappas.
It's Ida.
Hey, baby. I was just thinking about you.
Well, don't.
Don't what?
Think about me. I'm not gonna be meeting you at the diner, Barry, so don't bother showing up.
What do you mean?
Mr. Litvak offered to pay me twice as much money to dance than you ever did. He's a really nice guy, and he told me that he was going to introduce me to all kinds of guys who are really good-looking and successful. So I'm sorry, Barry, but I officially don't want to see you anymore.
Wait a second. Ida, you're talking crazy. I love you.
I gotta go.
She dumped me. She's working for Litvak.
Women. They'll do this to you every time.
No, not Ida.
They see a greener pasture, they're gone. It's tough to know who your friends are sometimes.
Litvak, that son of a bitch. I'll show him. Mr. Ordover, you didn't get anybody else to do the job, did you?
Barry, look, forget about it. I know you're not feeling sure on this one.
I'll do it. When do you want me to do it?
Thank you.
came out of the closet, Ray.
Well, look at the...
Only.
Hey, brother, your lights are on. Oh!
So, although Uncle Purvis did instruct me in the essence of escape maneuvers, I was never quite able to manage the art of dislocating my joints. Although they say that skill is actually hereditary, so I'm sorry about your sunglasses, Ray.
Well, at least they were good for something.
Those guys made me see terrible things to Barry.
Like what?
Like that I had to leave him for Shelley Litvak.
It's an interesting plan. I suggest we move quickly.
Please.
This is my invitation, pal.
Unless you have a warrant to go with that, I'm afraid you're out of luck.
I'm afraid your boss is in serious danger.
I find that hard to believe.
What are you going to do now?
Well, I'm sure it's not an insoluble problem, Ray.
What are you going to do, ask somebody for their invitation?
That's a good idea. Excuse me. I have reason to believe that the life of someone in that club is in danger. I wonder if I could use your invitation to gain entrance. Thank you, kindly.
Hi, excuse me, there's somebody in there who's in danger. You think I could... Pardon me, there's a man who's in...
Ladies and gentlemen, how about a great big happy birthday to the kindest, the handsomest, the most honest man you'd ever want to meet, the king of the Kit Kat Corral, Mr. Shelley Radham Cowboy Litvak!
Thank you, folks. Thank you. And thank you, honey. You said it just the way I wrote it. Should look. What the hell are you doing here?
Don't do this, Barry.
He's got a gun! He's got a gun!
He ruined my life, Fred. He took my Ida.
It was Ordover who had Ida kidnapped.
Yeah.
He forced her to make that call.
He's right.
He knew you'd be so angry that you'd try to kill Litvak for stealing your girl.
Right again.
Then where's Ida? Ida.
It's true, Barry. Everything you said is true.
Ida, you used to love me?
Yes, with very few conditions. One of them is that you put down the gun, Barry.
The other? You give us everything you have on Mark Bardot.
Ida.
Barry. Oh, my Barry.
All right, folks. So much for the showdown. Let's start the hoedown.
You know, Benny, those glasses were driving me crazy. I think I'm done with this superstition thing. No more lucky pennies, no more magic pencils, no more chanting.
You chant, Ray?
Well, not anymore. From now on, it's hard evidence and empirical logic.
It's a wise decision.
Excuse me. I was just at Ida's place. She found these on the floor and asked me to give them back to you.
Thank you.
If you ask me, though, you got such nice eyes, it's a shame to cover them up.
Really?
Yeah. Would you like to go out for a coffee or something?
I'd like that very much.
Yeah? Great. Hey.
Oh, watch out for that crack. Bad luck.
Sky will carry you away. You know you have to leave here. You wish that you could stay. It's four directions on this map, but you're only going one way.
Due south, that's the way I'm going.